أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Today we will take a museum. Museum is a place which is used for storing, preservation and exhibition of objects of natural history, art, culture and objects of antiquities. And it is a place, it may be a building, it may be a room which is used for storing and in which we store, we preserve and we also make exhibition of objects. Those objects which are very important so far the natural history of that area, of that country or that state is concerned. Objects of art, objects of culture and objects of antiquities. The objects which were used in the past and are no more used today and which are concerned, which are related to the culture and art of the people living in that area. What we do, we preserve, we store and we make exhibition of these objects in these museums. And these objects are mostly not found in the present scenario, but they were used in the past. We preserve them, we store them and we also make exhibition of these objects. So that we can know about the natural history of that area, we can know about the art of that area, and we can know about the culture of that area. In a museum, there is a collection of animal skeletons. A museum contains a collection of animal skeletons. Animal skeletons. Insects and birds preserved in boxes, and also various specimens preserved in, there are various specimens preserved in containers. Preserved in containers and jars. These containers and jars containing preservatives like formalin and alcohol. Formalin and alcohol are used as the preservatives, and it also contains a collection of plants and animals. Plants and animals and their parts, and we have collection of plants, animals, parts of plants and animals which are stored and preserved in a museum. Those plants are preserved in a museum which we cannot store, which we cannot kept in herbaria, and those plants are preserved in a museum which we cannot store, which we cannot kept in herbaria, such as algae, fungi, mosses, ferns, parts of gymnosperms, fruits and underground storage organs, etc. And those plants and parts of the plant which we cannot kept in a herbaria, they are stored in the museums, like algae, fungi, mosses, ferns, parts of gymnosperms, fruits, underground storage organs. And these substances, these objects, as I have already told you, these are preserved in chemical solutions. These chemical solutions contain borax, The chemical solutions are borax, silica gel, glycols, etc. And the specimens which are stored and preserved in museums, the specimens are correctly identified. We identify these specimens and properly identified and properly labeled, and they are stored and catalog is prepared for future references. They are stored, yani these specimens are stored, first they are identified, properly labeled, then they are stored and catalog is prepared for future references. We make a catalog list of these objects which are preserved and stored in a particular museum, and a catalog is prepared for future references, so that the people which will come there, they will know about the various objects, various things which are, various organisms which are found in this museum. Some important museums of the world are Museum of Natural History, New York. Some important museums of the world are Museum of Natural History, New York. And the second is Museum of Natural History, National Museum of Nature, National Museum of Natural History, Natural History, Paris. Similarly, we have in India National Museum of Natural History, New Delhi. Natural History, New Delhi. And in India, we have the largest and the most important museum that is located in Delhi, that is known as National Museum of Natural History. Now let me repeat, museum, it is a place used for storing, preservation and exhibition of objects of natural history, art, culture and objects of antiquities. In a museum, there is a collection of animal skeletons, insects and birds preserved in boxes, and various specimens preserved in containers and jars containing formalin and alcohol, and also dry specimens of plants and animals. Those plants are preserved in museums which we cannot kept in herbaria, such as algae, fungi, mosses, ferns, parts of gymnosperms, fruits, underground storage organs, etc. These are preserved in chemical solutions like borax, silica gel, glycols, etc. The specimens are correctly identified and properly labeled. They are stored and catalog is prepared for future references. Some important museums of the world are American Museum of Natural History, New York, National Museum of Natural History, Paris, and National Museum of Natural History, New Delhi. The importance of museums. The museum has a collection of plants and animals from different areas. As I have already told you, museum has a collection of plants and animals from different areas. Number second, if there is a collection of plants and animals living in different areas, they are important centers of taxonomic studies. They are important centers of taxonomic study. And these museums, they play an important role. They act as the important centers for taxonomic studies. If we want to study about the taxonomy of various plants and animals living in an area, we will simply go into the museum and we will know about the taxonomy of those organisms. Number third is they provide information about the flora and fauna of an area. What is the plant and animal population of an area? We will get this information from a museum. They provide information about the flora and fauna of an area. Number fourth is that they provide information about the cultural history, about the cultural history of an area. Any importance of museums? The museum has a collection of plants and animals from different areas. Number two, they are important centers for taxonomic studies. And number three, they provide the information about the flora and fauna of an area. Number four, they provide information about the cultural history of an area. This is all for today. Thank you.